I have had a great morning with you, and I hope you will stay with us during the evening and share in social media using hashtag NLNW2020. The next program is from GlobalGirl Media. I am personally really excited about this program because when I was a kid, I always wanted to be a journalist or a ski jumper, but I'm afraid of heights, so much for that. It is super amazing to hear more about GlobalGirl Media, that is an international digital journalism training and news platform that puts girls behind the camera and at the center of the story. We will first screen several short pieces from Athens, Greece, and then have a discussion from the young woman journalist in training. After the screening, just click the Zoom button on the website to be able to join the conversation and ask your questions. I hope you can join.
My name is Adele. I'm 17 years old. I'm from Afghanistan, but I born in Iran and I grew up in Iran. We left because Afghanistan wasn't safe for my family, and we couldn't go to a school, nothing. I never felt welcome there. Right now I'm like 1 year and 7 months I'm in Greece.
Mahmunir is my friend. She told me how good her school is. Every morning I leave my home to meet her. We meet under the lemon tree in front of her house. Then we walk to school.
My name is Mahmunir and I am 16 years old. Adele and I met in Greece and we became a good friends. I studied for 7 years in Afghanistan, but I did not feel safe at my school. Even on the way, there would be men on motorbikes who throw acid on our faces. Or in school, they would put something in the water that would make us sick.
Θέλετε να φύγετε, να πάτε πού?
Ναι, λέγομαι Ζαχαρόπουλος Ηλίας, είμαι μαθηματικός, είμαι 40 χρόνια στην εκπαίδευση και είμαι διευθυντής σχολείου. Το σχολείο αυτό είναι το μόνο γενικό λύκειο, είναι το μόνο γενικό λύκειο σε όλη την περιοχή της Δέλτα Διεύθυνσης Δευτεροβάθμιας Εκπαίδευσης Αθήνας, το οποίο δέχεται πρόσφυγες και μετανάστες. Το σχολείο απεφάσισε από το Σεπτέμβριο, μετά από πρόταση του Διευθυντή, να μπούμε στο πρόγραμμα και να δεχθούμε παιδιά πρόσφυγες και μετανάστες στο σχολείο. Έχουν δικαίωμα στη μόρφωση, έχουν δικαίωμα να ονειρεύονται, έχουν δικαίωμα να γίνουν κοινωνία της ελληνικής εκπαίδευσης.
Πιστεύω ότι όλα τα παιδιά είναι ίσα και αντιθέτως νιώθω υπερήφανη που υπάρχουν παιδιά στο σχολείο μου, τα οποία είναι πρόσφυγες και νιώθω υπερήφανη για το σχολείο μου.
Πάρε το πρόγραμμα.
Πολύ ωραία.
My school is the best school that I see in my life.
There are many students from other countries like Egypt, Ghana, Pakistan and Georgia.
Γλώσσα. Πρώτη ώρα γλώσσα.
Όσον αφορά τους πρόσφυγες, δεν έχω κανένα απολύτως θέμα, επειδή και εγώ είμαι από άλλη χώρα και εντάξει, τα βλέπω όλα σαν φίλους, αδέρφια και αυτά, δεν έχω κανένα θέμα. Ήταν πολύ ντροπαλές βασικά, αλλά τώρα που νιώσα και καλύτερα, είναι πάρα πολύ καλά κορίτσια, πραγματικά τις λατρεύω, είναι πολύ γλυκές και αυτά, πολύ φιλικές, κοινωνικές. Τις έχω συμπαθήσει πάρα πολύ.
In the future, I want to be a cardiologist, to take care of people's hearts. And I wish for all of these people all over the world to have the happiness I have found here under the lemon tree.
Freedom for me is life.
Freedom for me is the oxygen of the soul.
عندما أحقق أحلامي أكون قد حققت حريتي.
Looking at the sky for me is freedom.
Freedom for me is getting closer to fulfilling my wishes.
عطر شکلات تلخ برای من بیانگر آزادی.
Sky.
Oxygen.
Life.
Love.
Wish.
Chocolate.
Freedom is a big word with a lot of meanings.
I would say that freedom is mostly in your head, in your spirit.
For me, is doing what I like and what I love without any prejudice, without being judged.
Our freedom is to have space. You can talk. You can speak out your mind.
Open the border! Open the border!
It is a feeling that nothing can stop you, that you can go wherever you want without any anxiety.
Freedom. Freedom is everything. Freedom is to live the life that you want to live. Freedom of expression is to have the right to think first and afterwards to express your opinions freely without being afraid that you are going to be punished or you are going to lose your freedom and you are going to be sent at the prison or you are going to have other problems in your daily life. Freedom is everything, even this, the discussion that we have between us, is freedom.
The color of freedom is green to me. It means peace.
The main color for freedom for me is the blue, because it can mean like the infinite of the sky and the sea.
My favorite color is black. Okay, I would choose black. Not for freedom, for everything.
Λευκό. Λευκό που έχει μέσα όλα τα χρώματα παρόλο που δεν φαίνονται.
Η δική σου ελευθερία σε σταματάει εκεί που ξεκινάει το λουνού. Να μπορείς να αναπνέεις, να χαμογελάς και να κοιτάς την κάθε μέρα χωρίς να σκέφτεσαι ότι υπάρχει κάποιος ο οποίος σε περιορίζει.
Αζάντι! Τζεν! Τζεν! Αζάντι! Τζεν! Τζεν! Αζάντι!
Yeah. It's when the lady has a free time, she can do everything.
Ελευθερία. Πιστεύω είναι κάτι που δεν μαθαίνεται στη ζωή από μικρή ηλικία. Γιατί από μικρή ηλικία σου μαθαίνουν πώς να κάνεις κάτι, πώς να κάνεις το ένα, πώς να κάνεις το άλλο, αλλά δεν σου δίνουν την ελευθερία να πράξεις μόνος σου όπως πιστεύεις.
Ναι, και μασαρά, αζόντωση, τζόι και μυρί, αζόντωση. Άθρο μαρτί μου που κουνί, πα...
Μα, βελώς γιακ μόγερ, ανούς τάμ αζόντωρα να τσέσετε. و احساس میکنم کسایی که واقعا در این دنیا آزاد هستن خیلی خوشبختن.
Welcome to the Zoom discussion at the No Labels, No Walls Plus We Are One Festival with Global Girl Media. My name is Anita, and I will be hosting the discussion today. This meeting will be recorded and published later at No Labels, No Walls website. First of all, I would like to thank you for the great videos we just saw. As I said before, your program, I'm really excited to be here with you to discuss, and I'm so inspired by the work that you do. We have seen some of your work now, but I would like to ask you to introduce yourself to the audience a bit more, please.
Sure. Hi, everybody. Thanks for watching. My name is Amy Williams. I am the founder, co-founder, and executive director of Global Girl Media. We are an organization that trains young women worldwide in citizen journalism and activism using digital storytelling. And we are coming to you live from Athens, Greece, our latest project with refugee, migrant, and Greek young women. The videos that we just screened were produced last year, our inaugural program in Greece. Just briefly, we are in South Africa, Kosovo, Guatemala, London, Chicago, and Los Angeles. And our overall mission is to address the gender inequity in all media, film, television, broadcast, print. And through our training, we try to track young women ages 16 to 25 towards a career in those fields. And we've been at it about 10 years. We have lots of success. And I'm just thrilled to introduce a group of young women, one of whom took our class last year. And these are three new. We are about to start a whole new training. I want to briefly introduce also our partners, because we do work with men, by the way. We work with local stakeholders to help us do the programs in each location where we launch a program. And so our new partner in Athens is Odyssey, which you want to just give a brief background.
Hello. Yes. Hi, I'm Floris. I'm a program manager in Odyssey. Odyssey is a nonprofit organization that offers vocational training to people who need it, people that are trying to find their way and be integrated in our society. So we are offering these courses in order to give them empowerment and connect them with the Greek job market so they can support themselves and be equally integrated in Greek society.
Great, and I just briefly introduce everybody. There's a couple of global girls that actually joined the Zoom, but we'll start with the ones in the room. Just drop your mask and say your name and where you're from. I can't see you. Here, there you are.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mahmouni from Afghanistan.
Come closer.
I'm Mahmouni from Afghanistan, and I'm 18 years old, and I have been in Greece like 3 years.
Hi, everyone. I'm Fatima. I'm 25 years old, and I've been here for 1 year.
It seems like 20 years. Yes.
Hello, everyone. I'm Elena Yakubi. I'm from Afghanistan. I'm 19 years old. I have been in Greece about 1 year.
Hi, everyone. I'm Nasime. I'm 27. I've been here for 1 year.
Okay.
We're so excited to have you, Anit.
There's one girl on the Zoom call that used to be in Greece, and she's now in Germany. Ariane, are you still there?
Yeah. Hello, everyone. I'm Ariane Ashuri. I'm living in one refugee camp in Germany. I had took training with Global Girl Media in 2019, which I have learned amazing things, and I experienced like the things which it add to my experience for my life. And I'm very happy from joining to this Global Girl Media.
Great.
Great, thank you. Was that all in introductions?
Yeah, I think that's it for introductions.
Yeah, great. I think we can go to the questions. And we have a couple of questions that people have asked. Could you tell us how you started in Global Girl Media?
Well, I'm a filmmaker and a journalist, and I had been working a lot in the developing world, and mainly in Africa and North Africa. And I just found it very interesting that there were so few young women that had access to training that I had in the United States. I'm American. And that the that overall, the field of media is so dominated by a male perspective and a Western perspective, mainly BBC, CNN, and Hollywood. And the stories that I was tracking myself as a journalist and interested in, and the young women that would come up all the time in villages, in refugee camps, and ask to put their hands on the camera, it just kept happening over and over again. And I just felt like it was my duty to share the resources and the knowledge that I had if ever there was going to be a change. I do have lots of people that helped me start this organization. Most of them are in the locations I spoke about running these programs. Amazing women, also professional women in media and journalism, that just decided to volunteer their time in some cases. We do have funding, but very little. And we basically do it at the grassroots level. We go into a community, we identify a partner, like in Greece, it's Odyssey. And then we help build up from the grassroots groups of young women to give this training to. These girls came to us through various organizations. And I really, you know, really want them to speak on what little time we have, because oftentimes these forums and even panel discussions are always a white older woman telling you the story. And it's really important that you hear directly from them as to maybe why they want to take the training and why they want to be journalists or filmmakers. So can we move the discussion in that direction? Yes? So maybe Ariane, you can start. What attracted you to Global Girl? Why was it important for you to take this training? And what did you learn?
From the time that I joined GlobalGirl Media 2019, I was like living in one country in Greece where was many refugees was living there, and their voices was silent. Their voice was not unheard. So I joined this to become a journalist, to take the camera and report those facts that they are going to behind, or somehow there are some people that they are forcing them to be silent. They're not taking this bravery to stand up and speak in front of the media. And during the time that I was had a training with GlobalGirl Media, I have attended to the Athens Democracy Forum, where it was a big conference, and I attended inside this conference, which I learned many things. I was standing with my camera, speaking and reporting the voices of young generations, that it really changed my life completely. And I became the person that I can stay more active than the person that I was 2 years ago.
Great. And how about you, Mama Nir? Mama Nir, by the way, was the girl in the Lemon Tree video that some of you watched. She produced that with her friend Adele. Do you want to speak about why it's important for you to do this work? Come closer so they can hear you.
This class is important for me because I want to be in future a journalist, a woman journalist, and a filmmaker to make a story about the people who the world, they cannot hear their voice, and I can help them to how to save their voice to what can hurt. Sorry, my English is not good. I don't know how to explain it.
I'll just jump in really quick because I'm going to introduce two women who just came back from Lesbos. Those of you who follow the refugee story, the major camp, refugee camp on Lesbos, burned to the ground 4 or 5 days ago, leaving 13,000 homeless on the streets as they scrambled to build a new camp. So two of these young women just came to Athens from, they lived in Moria, and we are now trying to put together a story about what happened. But they shared with me that so many journalists come through the camp and researchers, to try to understand the refugee situation. And they report back to newspapers, on television, and yet the actual people that they're reporting on, it, oftentimes the story is not accurate. Many times it doesn't give them dignity. It frames them as victims. Invariably, most of the stories are male dominated. There's a male reporter going in and asking a woman, how does it feel to have a baby in a camp? And it's very different dynamic when you have a young woman from the community going in and telling her own story. So could you talk a little, come closer, talk a little bit about why it's important for young women like yourselves to tell your own story about the refugee story.
I want to say that recognize the privilege, but I think it's important because nobody knows what's going on in the camp. If the people living there can make you feel, that's my personal idea, it's gonna be real. Because that was the, that's what we experienced. What about you, Elena?
And why it's important for you to write music about, Elena writes music and she's done some of her own video work. Why did you do it?
Because almost about 1 year I lived in Moria and all the refugees were together and we are very close. And actually we didn't feel each other. We can feel our pain and we live together. And because of that, I really feel that, and I try to show my emotion and express it. And sometimes I try to make a short song and make my say my feeling and sing and it's playing guitar. Because really, I feel it, especially about refugees now, the very suffering about the situation of Moria. And I don't help really, but I can help almost about my art to say the pain of the refugee that's really suffering.
Do you want to come? And maybe you can speak it in Farsi and then she can translate a bit. So let me just say that this is a brand new global girl who's come to our class and she's basically begging to be part of the class. It was closed. We didn't have an open space, but she's very motivated to take the class. And so this is what she's going to talk about as to why this is important to her, like specifically getting these skills and why she wants to report. And she'll speak in Farsi and then we'll translate, okay? That's another thing that I find very interesting about the media is that we're always reporting in the dominant language. The dominant images and dominant language is English, and we require refugees to learn this language. And we feel that when they can't speak in this language, that they don't, they're not worthy of our time or our efforts to tell their story. One of the things Global Girl does is we report in the local languages and we use subtitles in English. So we're privileging the voice, and we have to understand a lot of times they're going from country to country and learning first Turkish, then Greek, which is, I can't even learn it. It's a very difficult language, and then English, and they're learning them all together all at once. I mean, Ariane was teaching me Greek. So I think this is also something to think about in media is what language are we reporting in? And when we ask a question in English, to somebody who that's not their first language, how can we break this down so that they feel more empowered to speak in their own language? So that's what she's going to do. So why she wants to take the class so desperately? Why did she come here and say, I want to take this class?
As Nasuna said to me, because she wants to say, the refugee's life is very different, and because of that, she sometimes wants to report something as a journalist, especially for refugees that are refugees with other, for example, we live in Greek, for other Greek people, we are equal, there's no difference between us, why they should try to ignore our refugee life.
and we try to some of them, not all of them, some of them try to push refugee and be racist. She is really suffering about that. She wants to show it. Yes. Also, she said some people think that refugees are all of them. They don't have any education. They are in very low class. They don't know anything. But she wants to say no. All of refugees are not like that. Because the refugees migrate because of maybe about the country is not safe and they want to improve their education. And they also want to improve, they don't want to just they don't want to humiliate each other.
To feel humiliated.
Yes.
Yeah.
They want to really improve.
So we can take some more questions.
Yeah, great. We actually had one question in chat, just a second. And also someone said that sometimes when you are a bit more far away from the microphone, it's a bit hard to hear. So I don't know if it's possible when someone is speaking, if you can then move a bit closer to the microphone so you can hear. I understand it's a bit hard in this kind of times. Just a second. We had the one question in the chat that is, what kind of challenges you have faced as a journalist in Greece?
Well, I actually personally don't report for Greek media because my outlets are global and usually in the US. GlobalGirl Media is creating its own platform and its own ecosystem of information because there's very little in Farsi, Arabic. We haven't worked directly with Greek media, although we use Greek journalists as mentors and guest teachers during our trainings. We've worked with some really phenomenal women journalists here in Greece. So I know that Greek media has its own challenges, but that's a huge political discussion and I don't want to get in trouble going there. I will say this, that the representation of the refugee problem or the refugee story, not problem, in the Greek media has been really difficult in terms of its accuracy, the overall...
It's one-sided.
It's one-sided. This is from a Greek guy. You want to speak directly?
It's really one-sided because... we don't really get the story from the refugees themselves in public media, like TV or radio or whatever. I have a reason in my mind as to why this is happening. Maybe you have it too. but I don't want to dwell on that because we here always try to find the positive view and we're always trying to listen to the story from whoever has to tell it. So this is why we decided very gladly to host the next course of Global News Media and this event also. But just to finish my comment on the Greek media, especially, there is a tendency to promote fear and
division.
Division, like we fear what we don't know and what we don't understand. And of course, we have no idea what these people have gone through and are still going through. But maybe some media trying to pose them as a threat to our society. This is a huge problem. This is what all our work is for. And this is what all our mindset is focused on.
And also, I will say this, working in the NGO space, servicing vulnerable people and communities, there's also a tendency in the NGO and funding space to see them as other and make the classes separate And what I love about Odyssey is from the very beginning, they brought young Greek people and migrant people together to do classes together, so that within the training, there's also a organic interaction and breaking down of stereotypes and difference. And we are also doing that now with part of our participants this year will be Greek women. Because let's face it, the Greek economy is still really challenged. And there are very few jobs. There's very few jobs in media in general globally because media's at this crossroads. So our goal, besides having these classes and giving these trainings, is to actually think creatively about how we can monetize and how we can actually find jobs for these young women and how they can get paid for their content.
Thank you. We had one question in Finnish. I will try to translate it to you. What is the biggest barrier for young women to be represented in media and to be able to, to be represented in media? I think that's the translation in English.
Well, for me, I'll just say that it's not just the barrier for women and gender, it's also an economic barrier. So lower income communities have a very difficult time paying for the training. Media training and film schools and journalism schools at the higher level tend to be expensive and or non-existent in some places, certainly not in refugee camps. And so that's the first one is economics. And I would say that's a huge one. The second one is just patriarchy and male dominant narratives and men who are editors, and the statistics are really crazy. The Gina Davis Institute and the Women's Media Center in the United States, they come out with reports every year, and they've shown over the last 5 to 10 years, there's been no improvement. Actually, the numbers are going down in terms of percentages of women directors in Hollywood, percentages of women editors of newspapers. If you don't have women in clout decision-making positions, deciding what stories get told and made, you know, there are plenty of women reporters. There are plenty of women filmmakers, and whether or not they get funded or whether or not their story gets greenlit, that still there's this barrier of men kind of dominating and deciding what stories get told. And what would you say is your barrier? Like you come to this new country and you want to be a journalist. What's the first barrier? Barrier is challenge.
For me, the woman, because I know the, because I heard in English, the woman is the same of other country, our country, and woman doesn't have a place like a man also. And I want to try to show that women, great women, all the women, not just refugees.
Great.
For me, about women, I want to say women,
bring your mouth down to
women in Afghanistan, of course, there in some country, we have equality between women and men, but in Afghanistan, especially, we don't have it. Yes, we should consider it because you should be the voice of the Afghanistan women, and you should show their feeling, their pain, and to prove the other country also.
I don't know if you heard that, but she said we should be the voice for Afghanistan women to report on their pain and their suffering, that this is their responsibility. Ariane, what do you think is the biggest barrier for you now? I know you've really struggled with your work and to try to stay active. And I mean, the main thing I see with Ariane is access to the internet right now, but you were able to join us, so that's great. What are some other barriers?
Yeah. First of all, like for me personally, I came from a country where the situation for the girls is too deep. Like they are not even allowed to talk in front of the media. And it's too far that they become a journalist and report the news. I was like going to learn English, like something somehow like hidely. But here, my father, he always allowed me, like, to be the person that I like to be in the future, to take the camera if I like it, to become a journalist, to report there's some facts that they are like somehow hiding by every day.
Great. Do you think there is something that every one of us could do to lower these barriers? For example, I'm currently living in Finland. I'm from Finland, and I'm like thinking what I could do to change things maybe in my daily life, or like, what could I do? What do you think?
Great question. What can somebody in Finland or in Europe do to change this for refugee women, for getting more access to the news or stories? Any ideas?
I think this is ignored. Because now I'm afraid in 13,000 people in this week, and this Inman said, we can't say give for refugees. It's like a good people in this week. This, imagine you living this year in this long week without anything. How this would be.
I mean, I think it's education and trying to go using social media to find what are the alternative sources of news about refugees and then to share them on your platforms. I mean, this is the future of news. It's not to stay sequestered in your own social feed with all your friends, but to go outside, and Global Girl Media is one resource, but there are many. I'm going to throw out one of my favorite regular reports from the front lines on the refugee situation. It's called Are You Serious? SYRIOUS. I'll put it in the chat. Let's see. Are You Serious? How do I get the chat to go to everyone? Here we go. And these are independent journalists that are reporting on the refugee crisis throughout the world, essentially, but mostly the Mediterranean. And it's fantastic. And they link you to other reports of independent journalists, people covering Syria, people covering Tunisia, people covering Turkey, the pushbacks. While I've been in Athens, I've seen amazing reporting done, but they just don't have the audience. And many of them fold because they don't have the following and then the funding. So, but as an individual, you have an incredible power with your phone, and it's just following these independent voices and amplifying them on your own feed. That's a really simple thing to do.
Yeah, thank you. That's a good example of what every one of us can do in everyday life. We also had a question that was, how long is this course and how you can get involved?
Well, if you're from Athens, or actually from any location where we're active, if you go to our website, globalgirlmedia.org, you'll see all the locations where we're active. If you want to start a new chapter, you can reach out to me, Amy, A-M-I-E, at globalgirlmedia.org, or just send a message on our Facebook. And we help you start your own chapter if that's what you want to do. And it's a lot of work, and I can explain to you what goes into it. And the courses run between 3 to 6 weeks, and we try to do them 2 or 3 times a year. It just depends location to location. And so we've already filled the class for this. We're starting on Monday, but we should have another one in February or March of next year in Greece. But the schedules are different from country to country, so I don't know where that question's coming from. And by the way, we don't have any chapters in Finland. So the only thing, the mission is that it's all women, ages 16 to 25, and it has to be vulnerable communities, like low income or marginalized. It can be LGBTQ, it can be migrant communities, it can be of color communities, cisgender, just whatever you identify in your community as underserved.
Great, thank you. We had also other questions. How do you choose the stories to cover? For example, these videos we saw How did you decide that this is the story you want to tell?
Well, Ariane worked on freedom. So Ariane, you wanna talk about how you chose that subject?
When I took a training with GlobalGirl Media, we was like divided for two groups. That one group was working to the, that they was trying to be, come up with the idea or the title for their film. And the next group that I was with them, and like everyone had a different idea that which subject or which title they wanted to make a film about it. But this was also important that the where and how we're going to film this. And also we should remember that we are allowed to film this place or not. So finally we came up with the idea of like to make a film by the name of Freedom. And I think we was like around five or like, if I say right, I think we was like five girls we can see, and there was two women also that we started to work together and make a film as the name of Freedom.
And then you wanna say why you came up with your story? Yeah, come closer to this.
I made a video under the lemon tree with my friend. It's about, it's called We Made This because we wanted to show the different school between Afghanistan, Iran, and Europe in Greece. The, how the parents support the teacher, how they are speaking with the students in Greece, it's very different than Afghanistan. In Afghanistan, we are not allowed to speak with our principal like friendly, and with our teacher. But in Greece, the principal, if you see that, they are like friends with you. They never, they say that, I am higher than you, than, and like a teacher. We wanted to make video about this.
So the way GlobalGirl works is each, we put them in production groups, and then each group, they throw out different ideas, just like a newsroom, and they decide, the training basically starts with one question. What is missing from the media for you? What's missing? What stories are missing? And then from there, they brainstorm, and together as a group, they come up with many ideas, and then they pitch the ideas to the group, and then they decide. There's a lot of conflict, but then they learn how to work as a group, and they learn like what story is more important now and for what reason. And it's interesting from region to region what sorts of things young women care about. It's very different in South Africa, for instance. I mean, and it also has to do with what's happening in the world at the time, or in the, that location at the time. But we try to guide them and help them kind of really focus their idea, and that, but it's really their choice.
Thank you. And if you want to ask questions, the audience that's in the Zoom, you can maybe just write in the chat so we can pick questions up there. And we also have some more questions that people have sent on social media beforehand. What inspires you in the work that you do?
Is that a question for me or all the girls?
No, it's for all.
I'd rather they speak. So what inspires you? You play music, for instance. By the way, I shared Elena's video. She made a beautiful video with her song on our Facebook page. So you can, it's a black and white short video with her song. You can check it out later. And but I would say her medium is music first, right? And then video, right? But you want to, what inspires you to be write songs? What inspires you? What makes you want? What makes you want to create music?
I don't know. Afghanistan exactly. But I choose the music because I think art has a different option, and I choose the music one. And I think sometimes when I saw my feeling become so strong, I can't tell myself, and I want to write it and show it by music or singing song. Because I can't ignore my feeling,
because it's my feeling, and also I think it's my feeling is the same the other refugees of the other people. I can express it and what's that?
What inspires you? Inspire means what motivates you, what gets you excited to film. What makes you come to GlobalGirl? What makes you excited?
Because I wanted to make it.
Say. Say.
Because I wanted to make a story about the people's life.
So the people inspire you?
Yes.
People, yeah.
There's a situation.
Do you understand the question? Yes? Do you have an answer?
No.
No? Okay. How about you?
I think there is a lot of things to say because we have a lot of movies, we're seeing a lot of movies, and that means our life. That's how we're living. We're watching and something we're doing is with what we see. And I think it's really good to show the real life.
So, I mean, I think what she's saying, because I've had discussions with her before, is that the dominant narrative that we see, Hollywood or news, this is what shapes people's concepts of each other, right? And you can't be what you can't see. And if we don't see enough of the reality of a young woman's life, then, and they're constantly seeing a false reflection, then the inspiration isn't going to be there. So I think what she's saying is that she's inspired by the reality around her and wanting to show that. Is that right? Is that kind of,
yeah.
Great, thank you. We have one question in the chat. If you could do a document or story from any topic you ever wanted, what would be your dream story? And this question is for everyone.
That's a great question. If you could make a story about anything, what would be your dream story?
Can I go?
Yeah, go ahead, Arian.
Nowadays, I'm working on my other film, which the title is No One Is Illegal. And the only purpose that I had is to show for the world that the refugees that they are coming to Europe, they're escaping from the war, from any other kind of problems. They have a dream to just feel like they are living like other human beings. And I have the only dream to show for the world that no one is illegal. They're all human beings that they're coming to this Europe and they want to have a safe life. Like other people.
Great.
Last one.
You
want to
tell your story? Yeah.
Last one said, her story is about that. Because she said most of the refugees, when they migrate and when they arrived she was coming from Iran to Greece. And in Iran, she did something and for herself and she improved it. But when she arrived, for example, in Greece, she should start from zero again. She should start from zero again, and some of the people from the government ignore the refugees. She said they should encourage us to improve ourselves, or like other people.
Is this the story you wanted? The question is, if you had any story to tell, what would it be? This is the story you want to tell?
Yes.
Yes.
Thanks.
Yeah, go ahead. Yes. Come closer so they can hear.
In the way we came from Iran to Greece, we saw lots of things, lots of war things. And also I saw lots of strong women to help refugees. I want to make a movie about them. Because I saw like Amy and all the women support me. Because they are really nice, and this woman gave me a spring to live. I want to make a movie about these women.
Actually, you know, she's right about that. I want to just tell you a brief story. My dream story also is to show women solidarity around the world and how they're working to help each other. The last 4 days were something horrific. And when you cover crisis, whether it's war or displacement, the stories are always horrific, let's face it. But within those horrors are stories of amazing strength and hope and humanity. And there's an NGO called Yoga and Sport for Refugee that was founded by two French women. And they started a gym outside of Moria, and refugees like Fatima would go every day to train in gymnastics, yoga, kickboxing, parkour. When the camp burned, they took all of their gym members and gave them shelter. None of the bigger NGOs, the UNICEF, UNHCR, they were not bringing in water and food, and many people were really suffering. So these girls hiked with backpacks full of food every day. They're like 20, 25, 26, you know, with 40, 50 kilo backpacks on the, so they could feed 40 to 50 people. And they were so motivated by this. And, you know, they dedicated their career as volunteers in the movement to empower refugees. And this is just one example. And the way women operate, we tend to do things no matter what, like if we have no funding, if we have no support, we see a problem, we see suffering, and we just, as women, we just have this instinct to help. And what I'd like to see is how this crosses all cultures and barriers, so that it isn't just like a Western white woman coming to help these poor refugees, but that it's a sharing of stories and support, because I get amazing support from them just by their trust and the time that I get to spend with them. They give my life meaning. And we are equals, even though I might have a lot more years of education and I might have access to things they don't, I still see us coming together to make the world a better place. And so her wanting to make a story about me is me wanting to make a story about her, and sort of globally how the female or the feminine power is rising, and how what we're showing to the world is that there's a new way coming, and that and I think it's the feminine identity in men like Theodorus. It's not just women, it's people that understand that that there has to be a new way. So that's kind of the story that I'd like.
Thank you. I think that's a great thing to share with others, and that's also one theme in this festival, that we come together from different backgrounds and we share and we inspire each other and do something new together. And thank you. We still have 5 minutes left, and we have one question I would like to ask, and it's if there is a little girl somewhere in the world now listening to this, maybe, or maybe not even listening to this, but maybe someday going to YouTube and seeing this video, what would you like to say to this little girl that maybe wants to be a journalist and maybe wants the world to hear her voice?
I want to speak to a young girl, like somebody younger. What's your message? Maybe a young girl in Afghanistan,
your message to that girl or young girl that may want to someday become a rapper, someday become a journalist, someday make her life better even in that context?
When I compare Afghanistan for 10 years ago and now Afghanistan, it gives a lot of change. And I think before when Taliban came to Afghanistan, the women didn't do anything. But now at least they can go to school and need education. But of course we have lots of education for women. But I think if the women try to be strong and improve their situation, and they can find a solution, finally. They can improve like all women that live in Europe, that other countries.
You want to talk about, because you think about this a lot, about women that went back in Iran.
In Iran, in Afghanistan, people are just pushing you, almost men just pushing you to don't talk. I just want to say them, be courage and be your voice.
How about you, Ariane? Do you have a message, Ariane, to younger women?
I couldn't hear the question, sorry.
The question is, if you could give a message to a young woman coming up behind you, either maybe in the camp, living with you, or where you back home, if you were to speak to a young girl, what would you say to her?
I would just say that please stay strong. Like, these difficulties of daily life will never be like always. One day it will be finished. But the only thing is important for you is to stay active and never accept to stay the corner of the room. It's not something we should give up on it. We should always stay strong than the person that you was yesterday and learn something new.
Thank you very much. We are coming in the end of our time with this discussion, and I want to thank you so much that you were here with us today with this discussion. And I know we had a lot of questions that we didn't cover, but I think people can maybe find you on social media and connect with you later. We will continue with our next program soon. So thank you.
Thank you for including us. We really appreciate it.